The solar, planetary, and lunar powers, it may come as a shock to you, but the stars, planets, and moons that you look upon every day and night are indeed great magical entities. Descending from out of the celestial realm, they have chosen to incarnate into the stars, planets, and moons. Their magical path is one of many advanced magical paths, but it is a very important path. It is important, especially in regards to you, for it provides places upon which lesser souls may find development and magical advancement. Humans are not, by any means, the only race in the universe. The stars, planets, and moons are, indeed, conscious, sentient beings, each with their own personal natures. Under this topic, I am going to discuss each of these inner natures. I will begin with a discussion of the solar life. I will then discuss the planetary and lunar god/goddesses, in general, and then discuss, specifically, the inner natures of each. Along with discussing their inner natures, I will also talk about the auric effect of each, upon you. If you are ready, then let's proceed to the solar force. The visible stars are inhabited by advanced beings following the Yang path of development. There is no doubt that physically we need the sun in order to provide physical heat and act as a physical source for the positive solar energy needed by living things on Earth. As a night magician, you will become very sensitive to solar energy. As your depth in the night proceeds, you will need less and less of the solar energy. You want to be very careful not to receive too much sunlight and so become overcharged with solar force. This will definitely harm your magical workings. I have been to places where the night force was so strong that it acted much like a polarized lens and filtered the harmful energy of the sun from me. But these places are few and far between. If you wrap yourself tightly in your night filler, then you will greatly minimize the harmful effects of the sun day. Within this system though, because it is a yin system, there is also the dark sun day. It is also called the black sun day. The black sun absorbs too much yang energy and moves it to another time and place that is a yang system. The black sun is the source of all yin energy in this dark solar system. It is the parent force to the planetary and lunar deities. Let's examine this parenthood some more. You will remember that every human being receives its oversoul and godsoul from a part of the great whole, which is the earth goddess/god's oversoul and godsoul. In similar manner, the planetary and lunar deities receive their oversoul and godsoul from the dark sun day. So we have the dark sun as the sum of the whole, who then divides its eternal self into smaller pieces, who are the planetary and lunar deities, and they in turn divide their sum into individual sparks which become encased in the material world. The ancients knew, though enshrouded in myth, that the planets and moons are the physical vehicles of very advanced beings. You are familiar with your own physical body and the other vehicles that make up your material being. You also know that you have an aura that is charged with emotions and thoughts. When you meet someone in the office, for example, and come within range of their aura, you often sense things about that person. If they are feeling uplifted, or angry and depressed, you can sense that about the person. You also have found that, if you permit it, their aura may induce these same feelings in you. This is somewhat similar when we speak about the planetary and moon spirits having bodies. They do have bodies, and along with that, they also have an aura that is supercharged with emotions and thoughts that reflect the inner nature of their being. Their bodies are enormous and so are their auras. Thus, the effect of these auras is far-reaching. Yet, I want to say this, humankind are foolish creatures when they allow the stars, planets, or moons to rule their destiny. The effect of their auras may heighten the highest qualities in humankind, but they do not rule humankind's destiny. Your destiny is in your own hands and the hands of your oversoul. Remember this. Now, what effects do these great ones have upon you? When the dark sun runs strong through you, you find yourself filled with vitality and health. You are ambitious, proud, strong-willed, and face life with great courage. You have a very strong and stable personality. You have a great drive and zest for life. You are a very independent and confident soul. You are generally quick-witted, perceptive, thoughtful, and considerate. These are the things that the dark sun can bring out in you. You will soon learn how to increase the power of the dark sun that runs through your veins. You will learn how to do this through the night rites. The dark sun does run through everyone, to some degree, but can be greatly intensified by practicing the night rites. From the dark sun we proceed onward with the planetary and lunar spirits. The firstborn children of the father-mother dark sun are the planetary and lunar night powers. Each night power has elected to incarnate into a planetary or lunar physical body. They serve the noble purpose of giving a home to countless souls. They serve as father, mother, and guardian to all the souls incarnate thereon. They are beautiful, magical beings of the night spirit's power. They all embody the energy of the night soul. They all serve to help the progress and advancement of lesser souls. Think about this, you only live a span of generally less than 100 years, but they live a life that is many billions of years long. Thus, you should recognize them for what they are, and give them your energy, as best you can. Each planetary and lunar night power has followed a separate and unique magical evolution, which is ever ongoing, just as you have. The only thing is, that they have been at it a lot longer than you have. You find that, just as you are strong in certain inner traits and qualities, so the planetary and lunar night beings are. They have embodied certain magical qualities and forces from their magical growth and advancement. These forces and qualities make up their inner nature and are reflected in their auras. There is a science that is based upon the interplay of these forces, and others, on humankind. It is called astrology. It is based upon many factors and is a very real science. What you are going to do is study the inner nature of each planetary and lunar night spirit, and then the auric effect of that night spirit, on you, when it plays upon you, or others, the strongest. You will begin with the night spirit Mercury. Perhaps, it is here, that I should interject this bit of information. The names of the lunar and planetary night spirits are prefixed with the word night god or goddess. This is so, whenever you refer to them, as magical beings in speech, or addressing them in meditation. Although each lunar and planetary spirit contains a yin and yang side, there is one aspect that is predominate, just as there is in you. Let's return now to the night god Mercury. Mercury has always been represented as the winged god messenger. You can, indeed, think of Mercury as the winged night spirit in the form of a beautiful silver hawk. The hawk is the symbol of great magical attainment, and the night god Mercury has reached those lofty heights of the planetary oversoul. His very core of being is filled with night energy. His presence is filled with oversoul strength and the night power. Yet, his nature is that of a very warm being. He stands as the rock of the oversoul upon whom all may build their lives in confidence. He is sure of his place in the drama of life. His aura radiates with the power of the night command and direction. Thus, he fills your life with night direction when you are open to his influence. When you are attuned to his presence and power, you are filled with the presence of oversoul. You find inner freedom and independence in yourself, as the magical hawk. You find yourself as a seeker of wisdom, wherever it may be. His presence quickens your mental faculties and gives you good memory. You enjoy the pursuit of wisdom in reading and writing. His aura makes you perceptive, studious, and logical. You can be a strong leader in life. This is the power of the night god Mercury in your life. From the night spirit Mercury, you travel to visit with the night goddess Venus. Venus is a night planetary goddess who is very warm, vibrant, and alive with the night energy. She is filled with the energy of the oversoul and the night spirit, which she radiates in her aura to all beings. If you were to visualize her presence, you would see her attired in a flowing, red gown. She has beautiful green eyes, skin that is pale and soft, and her hair is long, flowing, and red in color. You find her a bit reserved and mysterious in nature. She is filled with the deepest of compassion for others. You know her as the morning star, the last to say goodbye. When you bathe in the presence of her aura, your inner nature becomes filled with energy. She fills you with a vibrancy and warmth for life. She gives to you an artistic nature and an energy for beauty, art, and music. You become a part of her compassion for all of life. You enjoy being with other people and spreading harmony, peace, and happiness among them. This is the power of the goddess Venus in your life. From here, you move to the next goddess, and one whom you call Mother, the Earth. The presence of Mother Earth is a very commanding one. She has a very strong sense of direction and purpose in her life. Yet, you find her a very compassionate and loving creature. If you could envision her presence, you would find her arrayed in a beautiful, emerald green gown and shimmering in the glory of the night spirit's light. She is a very magical and elegant lady. She is very much concerned with life and nature. When filled with the presence of her nature, you, too, become filled with a concern for life and nature. You sense the great importance all life and nature plays in your world. You feel very earthy and strong in the ways of the earth. You become a